from the crypt.
Good evening, creeps, and welcome aboard Tales from the Crypt's Airlines Flight 666, offering direct service from your living room straight to hell. As we will be experiencing some turbulence, we recommend that you keep your seatbelts fastened and your vomit bags handy. So slip on your dead set and get ready for tonight's in-flight entertainment.
It's a nasty tale about my favorite kind of ghouls. Dreadheads. I call it Came the Dawn.
Can't fool me with your Boy Scout smile. I know exactly what you're doing, and I'm not gonna do a thing to stop you. Right now, you're undressing me with your eyes, aren't you? Would it be more fun to do it with your hands? Hold that thought. But I go to the ladies' room, and we can get out of here. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, you're so... Excuse me. There's somebody in here. Hello? It's Ocupado. Could you turn the light back on, please? Hello? There's somebody in here. What are you, fucking deaf?
Hi, it's Roger. I wish you wouldn't leave messages like that for everybody in the world to hear. I'm on my way up to the cabin and, frankly, I'm bored stiff without you. Now, I know I haven't been a very good boy lately, but, I was hoping you could come up here and we could kind of work things out.
Thank you. help you?
I don't know what's wrong with this stupid truck. Would it like to break down?
I wish I could help you. I don't know anything about cars. If you want to get in here and warm up, then I'll call a mechanic for you.
Yeah. Nice car.
Thank you. Here, put this on.
Thank you.
Oh.
Well, I don't want to get it wet.
Oh, I'm not worried. You know, I really don't think there's going to be a garage open this time of night. Do you want me to just take you back to where you live?
You feel like driving all the way into the city? That's where I live. Damn. Do you know where the bus leaves around here?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I do. The last one left a few hours ago. This just really isn't your night, is it?
No.
The inn isn't far from here. Do you want me to call and book you a room?
No. No, I couldn't afford it. But hey, thanks a lot for trying, really. I'll just sleep in my truck tonight, and I'll just get some help in the morning, okay?
Oh, no. Look. Actually, now I'm not trying to be forward or anything, but my cabin's pretty large. I'd be grateful for the company, actually.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm positive.
All right.
My name is Roger, by the way. What's yours?
Oh, Norma.
Are you kidding me?
No.
It's incredible. Well, listen to this.
Yeah, so?
She's got a mean something. It's Norma, the Druid Priestess. It's one of the greatest operas in the world.
Opera?
Well, it's personal weakness. I like to curl up at night with a bottle of red wine, listen to opera, and sob. It's not a pretty sight.
What are we stopping here for?
I'm just going to pick up a few things for dinner. You like oysters?
Never had them.
Oh, you're gonna love them. I'd leave the heater on for you.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. You gotta do something about it, Dave.
Yeah. Hey, Ed.
Hi, Raj.
Yeah, do you have any crystal here?
Yeah, I do. I gotta go, Dave. I'll call you later, okay? Okay, bye. You believe that, my friend Dave? Somebody stole his truck last night.
You're kidding.
This place is getting worse than this city. You hear about that lady who got killed a few nights back?
Somebody got killed?
Yeah. In the woman's toilet over the restaurant. Chopped her up like a roasted chicken. Hacked off her arms. Split her right up the middle.
Jesus, Ed.
They both don't got a clue. Bunch of morons. You know what I think? It's the same guy who took Dave's truck. I dare that bastard to come in here. I'll put a hole in him the size of a Buick. I'll have to take him down to the morgue in a bucket. Is there anything else that you need?
Yeah, some oysters. You have any of those Malpequas left?
Yeah, I got about a dozen. It'll just take a sec to wrap them up.
Whereabouts did you say that truck was stolen?
About 5 miles down the road.
Roger, Can I take you up on your offer? Roger. Say something.
Sorry, hon. You got the wrong person. This is Norma, the druid priestess.
Who is this?
Son of a bitch. Yes. Shit.
Jeez. You warm me up a little?
Yeah, starting to.
Sorry it took so long, but old Ed's been hitting the moonshine again. Come in. Come on in.
Really? What?
Make yourself at home.
Wow. Oh, this place is really something.
Thank you.
Huh. Mind me asking what you do for a living?
Well, I import things, mainly from Europe. Use furniture and old knickknacks and bits of canvas with paint on them.
Cool.
Oh, you like the painting? You like weapons. It so happens that that axe was used during the French Revolution to chop off heads.
Really? Can I touch it?
Sure. See all those notches on the handle? 15. One for each head.
Is this for real?
As far as I know, it's just an axe. I inherited it and my business from my mother. Her philosophy was you attach a story to every object and then you jack up the price of the object. Mm. That's my mother, by the way. And the painting?
Your mother was some piece of work, huh?
She was. Why don't you go upstairs? There's a master suite up there. You can change and shower. There's some dresses in the closet.
Are you married or something, Raj?
Oh, no, the dresses belong to a woman who's no longer a part of my life.
Was she your girlfriend?
I'd rather not talk about the relationship. The important thing is that it's over.
Okay, I'll take a look. In there? Ago. Christ, you can still smell the perfume on him. Men, they're either cheating on you or cheating on someone else and using you to do it. But not with me. And boy, are you in for a big surprise. It's okay, huh?
If you looked any better in that dress, I wouldn't be able to stand it. It's not complete.
What are you doing?
Just indulging a little fantasy. Turn around.
Surprises. I love surprises. Give me a hint.
Well, this used to belong to Catherine the Great of Russia, and it's not cheap.
Can I see?
Sure. Over here.
It's beautiful.
It's always beautiful.
beautiful as the one who wears it.
Dinner's ready.
So after Norma discovers that her lover Polione has been unfaithful to her, she decides to commit suicide because she's broken the vow of chastity. But at the last moment, Polione joins her, and together they walk toward the funeral pyre as the curtain drops.
That's it? That's how it ends? The guy cheats on her and she kills herself?
Well, she doesn't do it because of him. She does it because she's broken
her vow. No, she should have taken the gold and split to Paris or somewhere. That would have been a lot more believable.
But not poetic. All operas are filled with love-sick martyrs who end up dying. That's what opera's all about. Love and death.
Love and death. I like that.
Sometimes I think my own life is like an opera. Or at least my relationships with women. I like strong women. I like all women. But I seem to bring out the worst in them. Don't get me wrong. I love them. The way they look. The way they smell, the way they talk, the demure way they go to the bathroom with their skirts hiked up around their waist, the way they laugh. So, that's me. What about you?
Like, what do you want to know?
Like, who you are, really? Like, what your name is? I know it's not normal. Like, why did you steal that truck? You did, didn't you? I'm not gonna tell anyone. I couldn't care less.
Then why do you want to know?
If you don't want to tell me the truth, that's okay.
No, I'll tell you the truth. I came up here looking for my husband. He told me he was on a fishing trip with his buddies for the weekend, and it turns out he's shacking up with some bimbo.
What happened?
I dealt with it. So now I can't go home. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
I understand.
You do?
You can stay here as long as you like. I don't know what it is, but I feel this connection with you.
I feel it too. Don't tell me you're one of those guys who always has to be in control. Didn't you say you thought strong women were sexy?
Yeah, but how do I know you're not gonna tie me up and rob me? Maybe even slit my throat? Who knows what you're capable of?
How do I know you're not going to throw me out in the morning?
Oh, I wouldn't do that to you. Can we just make love?
Sure we can. I just don't want you to touch me until I'm ready to be touched.
I don't think I can wait that long.
Sure you can. You're just going to have to trust me like you want me to trust you. Don't you think trust is sexy? So do I.
Dude, please, please, there's no time. You've got to go.
Don't touch me!
Let's go.
Bastard. Shit.
Do I have to do to her what I did to the one in the restaurant?
Calm down.
Come on, Roger. Why do we have to play these games?
Calm down.
Sluts like you can fool Roger, but you can't fool me.
Oh my God, Roger.
I'm gonna make you look like that bitch at the restaurant.
No.
I'll fix your ass for good.
Fun, but you gotta admit, redheads really know how to swing. So till next time, kiddies, I hope you'll excuse me, but I've got a little private business to take care of. It's the only way to fry. I've always wanted to join the Mild Die Club. Ooh.